Oh, the Banshees also got a health buff recently. I think it was maybe 2 patches ago, but they are a very robust unit. If you're used to StarCraft 1 with the Wraith, there's a little battle over here on the right side with one unit versus one unit. One Marauder versus a Zealot. I think the Zealot... Oh, nope, he got his legs back up, and oh, he's gone. So that Marauder just dancing around, able to take him out. Just a small battle there. And I don't know if he actually mentioned this, but obviously there's an expansion on the top left side as well. And a good thing about taking an expansion like that is you can put the gateways there, and you can warp the units anywhere. So it's not like in StarCraft 1 where you would never put a gateway on an island. You can actually hide them back there so you can take your opponent by surprise, or you can just keep them a little bit more safe. And so the expansions, though, are going to be even in count here. I really can't wait to see these Banshees in action, though, because they are not a Wraith. They are a whole new unit, and they can wreak havoc on a lot of different armies. So can't wait to see these move out and see. I wish I could see the look on Halu's face, because I don't think he realizes just how many there are.
Yeah, I don't think the Observer has gotten in here just to see exactly what he's dealing with. Let's go ahead and check it out real quick. Yeah, looking at Halu's vision, he does not know about all of these starports, and that's surprising because, I mean, there is a gap for an Observer to fit between these missile turrets. He could have seen these Banshees, and I don't know what's going to happen when the first battle occurs. I think the Banshees are probably going to be able to do a lot of damage, especially considering so many of these units cannot even attack air. This is going to be really bad for Halu, and he's going to have to make a critical change to his army composition when he sees these Banshees. And the Ghosts are coming in too!
Maybe Halu or Halu or whatever can do some crazy good storms. Oh, and he fed back that Ghost. He exploded into a bunch of Gibbs. And so the only thing that is going to help him right now is storms on the Banshees. Because like you mentioned, HD, not a whole lot of anti-air. I think there's only 3 sentries, 2 stalkers. Those Immortals, they're really good, but not against air. So I'm really curious to see how this battle is going to go, especially with the static defenses. We got a Planetary Fortress, a Bunker, but he's going to try and run in here anyways. Focus firing down the Immortal that was weak there, even using Stim to finish the job. And he's going to get one more Immortal. So this is definitely, and a worthless Storm right there. So this is definitely not off to a good start for Halu. He is going to have to go to Plan B, whatever Plan B was, because Plan A is not cutting it.
Yeah, this is not looking too good for Halu right now. And right now, Husky, what time are you at exactly? I think I might be a little bit of ahead of you right now.
I am at 1755.
Okay, I'm at 1805 right now, so I'm a little bit ahead of you. Not sure why that happens, guys, so we do apologize for the lack of sync. But it does look like Halu is going to fall back, and now the Banshee army is pushing out, and wow, this is so many Banshees, and no upgrades for the Banshees. Let's see if the Protoss army has any upgrades. One upgrade on weapons, and I think Halu right now realizes just how much trouble he's in. Warping in some high temps. I think the high temps do have enough energy to storm. That is going to be the only way that that Halu is going to be able to fend off this massive air army is with Psystorm. I don't see how else he's going to be able to deal with this. He needs more Stalkers, and a nuclear launch detected. Nuclear launch is coming in right now. Is Halu going to be able to pull back, Psystorm those air units and get out of there, Halu? Oh, you're going to lose so many units if you stay there.
Oh!
And the nuke is coming. The nuke is coming. Oh!
Yeah, he definitely didn't get his units out of there in time. I don't think I've ever seen a nuke actually land on top of the Zealots, or the army, rather. There they would go, chopping that Ghost in half right now. But yeah, so apparently he didn't realize the nuke was there. It was kind of the most obvious place to do a nuke. So not only is he down in the units, I mean, just mixture that he needs, he really, well, getting nuked in the face is never a good situation to be in. Although one thing I do want to note is that he is taking a bottom right expansion as well. So he may not be that far behind, especially if you look at Pain User's expansion over in the top left side. He has a command center floating there, but uh-oh, there is a base there. And it's even going to try and land on the Nexus. I don't know if you're catching a glimpse on that on the top left side. Hopefully I'm not too far ahead now. But yeah, he's going to be sadly surprised when he gets over there on the top left, realize he's not ahead as he thought he was.
Yeah, I'm actually at 2025 exactly right now. One thing I do want to say is looking at the production tab, we do have 4 battlecruisers in production as well as ship plating and ship weapons. So 2 upgrades for the battlecruisers. Immortals here getting up in there just a little bit too early, and these Marauders are going to be able to snipe out a couple of Immortals as Zealots charging in, pushing the Immortals back as all the Terran Army Pain User falling back to his Planetary Fortress. Psystorm going down, lots of action right now, almost reminiscent of a lot of Terran versus Protoss I've casted on Desert Oasis already.
That storm we saw just a second ago, I think actually did more damage to the Zealots than it did to his opponent. But either way, his army, it will be able to macro up here pretty easily because he has been ahead in expansions for a little while. And so especially since the bottom right one is going to start kicking in, it should be extremely effective here for him to get a massive army.
Oh, look at the top left.
What? I don't know if he realizes you can't lift that command center off once it becomes a planetary fortress. So he's actually going to, okay, I've never seen this. So this is definitely something silly. He's only going to be able to long distance mine there. And I can't believe he's not warping in units here, because he does have a pylon power there and he could warp in some units. So this is definitely unconventional, but very entertaining.
Here comes the units that you were talking about warping in. Four Zealots are going to be warped in. Are they going to be able to take down this planetary fortress before it morphs in time? About 10 more seconds to go. Oh, this planetary fortress is going to start to go to work. These Zealots absolutely stand no chance of this planetary fortress. And right now, Halu bringing in a warp prism with four High Templars. They're going to get some storms off, I think, on this expansion, the third expo for the Terran player. And here comes the storm. Is he going to storm? One storm going down. Going to catch a couple SCVs. Second storm, third storm going down. Going to get about five or six SCVs. Meanwhile, the planetary fortress going to work on that island expo, dispatches of all the Zealots, and now it's going to take down the Nexus as well as possibly a gateway and maybe a pylon as well. But look at this, we do hear a nuclear launch detected. I don't know where this is coming. This is coming at the third base of the Protoss. So much action on the map, and oh no, Halu is gonna lose one High Templar and potentially about half of his probes. Boom goes the nuke, and right now there's so much action going on.
There's also another ghost that was trying to take a little peek over here on this left side expansion. That's where he's nuking right now. The Immortal just waltzing over that. I don't know if he has any detection over here to deal with it. There are a bunch of Immortals there, so talk about a stressful workflow environment here for this ghost as he is like half a second away from death. What are you doing, Immortals? Get away from that nuke! And they do get softened up quite a bit as they just want to, you know, walk through that nuclear fire there. Not the brightest idea, but either way, the nukes are going down. I think that's our third or fourth nuke so far. And I, if you haven't caught a glimpse of those battlecruisers lately, there are a lot of them chilling in the base. Six are completed with more on the way and almost completed. And he is still only on two base, so he's going to have to make something happen here, though, as he finally did lose that command center on the top left side.
Yeah, let's take a look at the income tab here and just take a step back and look at the entire game in full, because so much action has been going on. We can't really just, you know, take a full-on peek of the entire game. Right now, the Protoss player Halu at 1,500 minerals per minute and 500 gas. So the Protoss player at a much stronger income. I think that might be due to the fact that he's got 92 probes compared to 41 SCVs. That's almost overkill on probes, I must say. Protoss player also at 5 bases, Terran only at 3. But the critical thing is Pain user, looking at the unit tab, has 8 battlecruisers in play. So I don't really know how to call it right now. The Protoss player might have a stronger economy, but the Terran player has the nuclear warfare threat as well as these massive weapons of war, the battlecruisers. So right now, really close game, I think, and all Pain user has to do to keep up in the long term is grab another expansion. Look at that! We actually saw the High Templar using feedback on the battlecruisers. Feedback does 1-for-1 damage for how much energy the BC has, and as well as draining all the energy of the battlecruiser, and now the BCs are going to go to work. That feedback not doing enough damage to kill them off.
There is also a raid over here on the natural outside the red player Pain user's base, and then there's 3 battlecruisers that are actually split up. Some of them are shooting the Immortals, some of them are attacking the base in the top left side, so I do not envy you trying to track all of this, as there are many battles on different fronts here, and they're going to try and snipe this command center, but the Immortals did not focus it down there in time, as they both have lifted off here, and so I don't think I've ever seen battlecruisers split up like this, and so he's having to micro 2 groups of battlecruisers while also trying to defend his expansion, and possibly going to lose this command center on the right side at the natural. And there is another command center trying to float down to another expansion, and this map is running out of expansions, but the top left side has been cleaned up. These poor probes, they just know what's coming, as these battlecruisers are happily shooting at these easy to kill targets.
Yeah, these battlecruisers are like taking candy away from the kids, as another command center is going to go in and claim this island for the Terran player Pain user. Exactly what Pain user needed to do. I said he needed to grab another expo, but he won up that bet and he actually took out a Protoss expo, and he's going to take over that one instead. So 1-for-1 there, really good for Pain user. Even though he did lose an expansion over here, it was almost out of resources anyways. And right now this BC fleet at 9 battlecruisers, that is absolutely insane. The only unit that I know of, the Protoss arsenal, that can deal with that many BCs is either stalking blinkers, blinking stalkers, excuse me, as we see Blink being researched, and of course the Void Race. So we'll